Bravo, questo. Can we just, ano, simply tell your name para this, nalalaman ko naman yung pangalan nyo and I would be connected with you. Okay? Yan, so si Alvan. Yun ang nalim, ha? Alvan Ray. Sa UP ka rin, no? Si Kim Joshua. Charmaine. Tommy. Bakit Tommy? Is it the, ano? JD. Ah, nagkamali, ano?
Kamali na tayo.
Okay. So, Amy, ano na? Tommy. Okay. This is Sir Arnold Schwarzenegger. Si Honey Joy. Yan. Yan, Jermaine. Jermaine. Shemriel. Combination yan ng parents name mo, no?
Lahat sila.
Lahat sila. Shemriel. Wow. So, who is the S? Sinong S?
S-H po.
Sinong E?
Si Daddy Everest, and si Mama Mabel.
Kasi my name also is a combination of my parents' name, Rovel. Romero ni Philip, si Gina Lee. Saka si Seth, Sir Jetro. Okay? Si Ma'am Joyce. Yung mga dalawa natin may kisig dyan. Mark, Ian. At saka si Ronan Keating. Sir? Hello. Luis. Okay, so welcome sa ating series. We'll be discussing one of the very controversial issue of life. And that is other than music. Tama? This is a very great controversy because we know that the devil, his master is about music. But before anything else, I would like to ask you, among these four, which comes first? Which first existed? Marriage, Sabbath, music, angels. Sige, have a try.
Music.
Okay. Music tapos. Sige, ano nyo? Chronological. Anong muna dyan?
Music, angels.
Tapos?
Marriage.
And
Sabbath.
You got it right. So it should be music, then angels,
marriage,
and then Sabbath. Bakit nauna music? Huh? May music sa langit. Sino magtutugtog ng music kung walang angels? Oh, nililito ko na ang utak ninyo. I just wanted to make sure kung talaga sure kayo sa mga sagot ninyo, no? Because we really need to make it sure kung ano ang tinatayuan natin. And we should stand on what we know, not just knowing what we're to stand. So at this moment of time, I'll be inviting you to bow your heads as we pray, as we begin our series about music. Father God in heaven, thank you so much for these young people. I don't know what are their struggles with music. They are just but few, but I know, dear Lord, that you could start a music warrior here in this congregation. Thank you that you will be using them. Help them to be prepared of what they will be hearing. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. So that's it. And for us to, para mas mapatibay pa natin yan, I would like you to open your Bibles with me in Exodus 15. Exodus 15. Yung isa po ay Psalm 118 verse 14. And the other one is Isaiah 12 verse 12. Okay, sinong nakahanap na ng Exodus 15 verse 2? Sige sir, Luis.
The Lord is my strength and song, and He has become my salvation.
Okay, the Lord is my strength and song, and He has become my salvation. Psalm 118 verse 14. Oh, aren't you familiar with that verse? Di ba kinakanta natin yan? The Lord is my strength and song. Psalm 118 verse 14. Tama? Sige, makibasa daw. Tami?
The Lord is my strength and my song.
So, what are the familiar things? Sana nakita yung connecting things ng first verse natin at second verse.
Song and salvation.
Okay, song and salvation. I think you're lacking something. Let's open Isaiah 12, verse 12. Actually, it's found there. It is three letter S. Isaiah 12, verse 12. Ano po sabi dyan? Walang 12? What's this verse? Isaiah, what's that? Yan. Ano yan?
Verse 2.
Verse 2, sorry. So it should be Isaiah 12, verse 2. Thank you for correcting me. Isaiah verse 2. And you will find these three, parallel objects with these verses. Now, paano natin masasabi na nauna talaga ang music before angels? Because the Bible says that God is our what? First, strength. Sunod, song. And our salvation. So before they existed, music began because God is a song. God is our song. Paano natin mapapatunayan yun? You will find that in many verses in the Bible, Zephaniah 3:17, and it explains that Jesus Christ is the song. So, before si Lucifer, it is God. Tama? It is God. It all reflects who God is. Now, I would like you to notice something here. Even Jesus Christ wanted us to understand what real music really means. Open your Bibles to Matthew 26, verse 30. Matthew 26, verse 30. Ano sabi niyan? See it.
And when they had sung an hymn, they went out into the Mount of Olives.
Okay, and when they have sung a what? Worldly song, they went to the Mount of Olives. Oh, you are not with me. And when they sung a what?
Hymn.
A hymn. They went to the Mount of Olives. Now, do you remember what is the context of that verse? Nasaan sila na panahon yan? Sa upper room. Lord's Supper. In other words, I would like you to see this. Even Jesus Christ is teaching them to know the right songs. And Matthew 26:30, sinabi daw, kumakanta daw sila ng hymns. At alam niyo yung hymns nila at that time? Kinakanta po ng ancient Israel or ng ancient Jews yung Psalm 113 up to Psalm 118. This is what we call Hillel. Nakuha natin yung word na Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Are you following me so far? I would like to see this. If Jesus Christ is teaching them the right song, and they are also having the right song, what do you think is the Bible telling us to do? We should know what are the right songs and what are the appropriate songs. Now, I would like to see this. Kung kinakanta nila ay Psalm 113 hanggang Psalm 118, saan sila mag-end the verse? Or saan sila chapter mag-end? Ano ang magkira nyo sa verse na yun? If you are following so far, this is the first three verses natin. If they start Psalm 113, and then a portion of Psalm 114, a portion of Psalm 115, a portion of Psalm 116, a portion of 117, and a portion of Psalm 118, ano ang meron sa Psalm 118? Ang meron po doon, yung binasa natin kanina, Psalm 118, verse 14. Are you following so far? Are you following so far? That the ends of every music should be talking about God as our strength and song and also our salvation. Now, let me tell you this. Don't you know that music is a reflection of who God is? Tama? Do you believe that so far? Kailangan kong ibigay itong katotohanan na ito sa inyo for us to understand how should we deal with music. Let me tell you straight. Ang tao po, kung gano'n nila kakilala ng Panginoon, gano'n din ang way nila ng music. Tama? Some of us think about God in heaven na meron siyang baggy shirt, baggy pants, may bling bling, and then, hey yo, it's cool here in heaven, dude. And some of us think that Jesus Christ is like, nasa langit na mahabang buhok, tapos nage-headband. Because that is our music. Are you following so far? Or some of us understand that Jesus Christ is a rapper. Something like in heaven, he is rapping. You know, gusto ko, it's as if Jesus Christ is like that. How we know God reflects our music. Let me put it this way. Kung kilala mo talaga tami si Jesus Christ, kung kilala mo talaga, if you are really enamored by God, personal evaluation, yung mga music pa na pinapakinggan mo ngayon, papakinggan mo sa harapan at sa tabi ng Panginoon mo. Praise God. How about the others? What kind of music do we have? Remember this, the way we know God reflects our music. The way we know God reflects our music, or our music reflects how we know our God. You know what? Before, akala ko ang Panginoon ay isang rockista, no? Na mabait. Kasi may mga kanta ko na ginagawa, kinocompose like, "You are holy, holy, to you be the praise and the glory." And for you to understand, I came from a rock and roll industry. And I understand kung gaano kabigat ang effect ng music sa buhay ng bang tao. And I thought, it is just something na parang simple lang, pero recognizing that it is hypnotizing to greater extent. Nagsimula ako sa simple plan. Alam niyo pa ba yun? Tapos Blink 182, Psalm 41. Tapos nag-escalate sa Atavis, Bowling for Soup. Alam niyo na yun? The Black Dahlia Murder, My Chemical Romance, Red Jump Suit Apparatus, All American Rejects. Are you familiar with those? And those are kind of music which are growling. Alam niyo ba, growling is screamo. With all those kind of music, I thought it is a right kind of music. Kasi yun ang pag-intindi ko sa Panginoon. And even my music in church, ganun din. Because that is how I understand my God. Am I communicating something here? Always remember that. Before we play any music, think of it. Is this reflecting my God? Or it is just reflecting how you know your God, which is not really who God is. Now, let me put it this way. If music represents who God is, how many major elements do we have in music? How many major elements do we have in music? Sige, let's make a try. I know you are very intelligent people. You are great people. How many major elements do we have in music?
Seven.
Somehow, the elements, those are the elements. But what are the major elements na talagang hindi mo makawala sa music? Now, let me give you a clue. If it is reflecting who God is, how many major elements does music reflect who God is? How many major elements do we have in music? Three. Why? We also have three in the Godhead. Is it a coincidence? Let me put it this way. What are those major elements in music? We have the melody, harmony, and etong lagi din i-sort yung patlo. Rhythm. Now, if, let me explain to you what is the meaning of melody. Melody is the what? The chief theme of a musical composition. Never forget this. Ibig sabihin, siya yung forefront ng music. Oh, shall we sing once again? Or shall we try to sing, Jesus is Coming Again? Can you have a pitch? Lift up the trumpet. This is a melody. Okay, let's try. Ready, go.
Lift up the trumpet and now let's sing. Jesus is coming again. Cheer up, the pilgrims, be joyful and sing. Jesus is coming again.
Okay, mamaya na yung harmony, mamaya harmony. The melody is the forefront of music. Tama? Hindi lang siya yung lyrics, kundi siya yung main theme na dapat napapansin po sa music. Now let me ask you, if music reflects and represents who God is, it best represents who God is. Kung ang melody ay siyang forefront ng music, sa tingin nyo, sino sa Godhead ang nagre-reflect ng melody na siyang forefront, siya ang mas ina-amplify, siya ang mas binibigyan niya ng pansin. Although, pare-pare sila, they are in equality and unity, but is the one given much attention. Pero they are still equal. Ganun din po sa music, the melody is the one who has given much attention, pero they are all equal with the harmony and rhythm. Who represents melody in the Godhead? God the who? Why God the Father? Because I would not like you to forget this. Kalimutan niyo lahat ng pwede natin pag-aralan yan, pero I don't like you to forget this. Because it really will tell how we should take good care of our music. Because every melody reflects God the Father. Kasi siya ang forefront, tama? Siya ang forefront. Now, what is the next one? Harmony. I-simple na lang natin, i-simplify natin. Ang harmony is a combination of notes and tones. Tama? But let's try that one. You may harmony.
Lift up the trumpet.
Sound your voice, no? Kung alto kayo, tenor kayo, kung baho kayo, tenor, tour, ano ba? Kung ano man yan, sige. Tell your song, okay? Bakit nag-read them yan?
Lift up the trumpet, ready, sing. With harmony, go. Lift up the trumpet, love and sing. Jesus is coming again.
Okay, isn't that amazing? That it could make well music, tama? And God knows very well the art of music. Now, if melody represents who God is or God the Father, who best represents the harmony? Why God the Son? Huh? Sige, sige, maganda yung sagot ni, ano, Joshua. Ano yung sagot mo, Joshua?
Harmony siya sa will ng Father.
Yeah. Sige, anong sagot mo, sir? Yes. He's in harmony with the Father, but let me explain to you this. He is the harmony that connects us, that combines us with the divinity and humanity. Tama? Nakikita niyo connection? If Jesus Christ is the harmony, He is the one who is connecting us to God the Father. Kaya pala sinabi ng John 14:6, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you want to have an enamored relationship with God, kanino kayo pumunta? Kay Jesus Christ, and He will direct you to the Father. Kaya pala pag nagpray tayo, our Father which art in heaven, in Jesus' name. Am I communicating something? So, kung dinidistort natin ang harmony, sinong dinidistort natin? Think of that very well. We are distorting Jesus Christ. Of course, hindi naman lahat perfect sa harmony. Tama? May mga kanya-kanyang pitch lang talaga. No? Wala naman talaga tinatawag natin libang, yabang. Kundi may kanya-kanyang pitch lang. Tama? May kanya-kanyang nota lang talaga. Merong SATB, no? Soprano, alto, tenor, bass, meron naman NEWS, North, East, West, South. But whatever it may be, at least nakikreate siya ng harmony. Now, the point here is this, harmony best represents Jesus Christ. Siya ang nag-connect sa atin sa Father. Now, what is the last elements of music? Rhythm. What is the rhythm? It is the movement of the song. Now, let me ask you, who best represents rhythm? Of course, the Holy Spirit. Why the Holy Spirit? Why the Holy Spirit? Yan ito. Yeah, that's it. Siya ang nagmumove sa atin. Kunwari, nakapakinig ka ng napakagandang music, you are the one He's the one moving you. Tama? I'm so much blessed sa kanta kanina ng mga kabataan because that is the movement of the Holy Spirit in us. Now, have you noticed also the devil wanted to distort rhythm in a wrong spirit? Tama? In a wrong spirit. So that is the way how music plays. Meron pa rin siya counterfeit though we have genuine music. Pero si Satan, magkakaroon siya ng counterfeit because anong role ni Satan sa langit? He's the choir master in heaven. Lucifer is the choir master in heaven. At sinabi sa Spirit of Prophecy, particularly in story introduction and some part of the Spirit of Prophecy, that pag kumanta daw si, pag nagsalita daw si Lucifer, may ilang boses? 4 or 8. Can you just imagine? He is really the master musician of heaven. But who is the one who created him? God. It's still God who have the right authority. Now, let me give a quiz, no? Para magkaroon tayo ng recap. Okay? Who best represents harmony? Oh?
Jesus.
Rhythm. Melody. Rhythm. Melody. Harmony. Yeah, you got it right, no? So never forget that. Kung naglaro tayo ng mga music na ano yun? We are creating a terrible rhythm. Ano yun? Sinang dinidistort natin? The movement of the Holy Spirit. And it's creating something else. Are you following so far? Kung yung mga lyrics naman natin ay okay naman, pero yung rhythm naman ay sublime, I think that's questionable. Now, let me point to you something. Don't you know na may experiment po sila sa DNA natin? Alam niyo tsura ng DNA? Di ba yung may ikot-ikot na gano'n? Tapos meron siyang mga protein sense. Hindi siya pantay-pantay. May mas mahaba, may mas maiksi. Now, sa bawat ikot na gano'n, yung mga protein sense na yun, nilagyan po nila ng speech, ng human speech. Nag-apply sila, ano tawag ito? Inanoan nila ng speech, yung bawat note na yun. And this is what it creates. Kung nagagano siya, ganito nangyari. The more po na malapit siya sa doon sa center, mababa yung note. The more na lumalabas siya, tumataas yung note. E iba-iba yun. I would like you to listen to this. Okay, have you heard that? Narinig nyo? Okay, let me pull it again. Sino sa inyo na pangayon ba? Na sa bawat DNA natin, meron siyang music. And if that is the kind of music that we have, papansin niyo, kahit yung music na yung mapapaisip ka, di ba kung gano'ng maganda, hindi siya something na mamumuk ka sa ibang klaseng book. But rather, you will ponder, you will be at peace, you will be at ease. Let me hit, another one is the, this is the Blue Human Center. And this is the notes. Okay, imagine that. That is the movement of the DNA.
It's beautiful, isn't it?
Wow. Can you just imagine? You have a built-in music in you. Pero ang gagawin natin, i-distort natin siya, what would happen to our body? Nadi-distort din yung rhythm niya. Our problem so far, if we are distorting melody, harmony, and rhythm, we are also distorting our body kasi ang binilkin niya sa'yo, Charmaine, ang binilkin niya sa'yo, Charmaine, is a music that will glorify God. Tama ba, Kim Joshua? That is supposed to glorify God. Eh, kung ako ano ng music ang kine-create natin, ang nangyayari, nadi-distort, nako-confuse yung katawan mo. Nako-confuse yung katawan mo. Let me tell you that even the heavens, it declares the glory of God. Can you read it for me? Go.
Harmony represents the moment of the heaven and the heart of the world.
Now, what are the major scales? Yung C, D, E, F. Tama? Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, dito. Yung planetaryo lang po, magkakaroon siya, magkakakreate ka ng over 90% of the tones created by the planetary proportions belong to major scale. Isn't that amazing that even the heavens explain music? At pag merong distortion sa planetaryo, anong mayayari sa planets natin? The same way with our body, kung dinidistort mo yung rhythm niya, dinidistort mo yung harmony niya, dinidistort mo yung melody niya, it will also distort the physiological effect of our body. And I hope that you will, I hope that you will take that with you. The second one is this. The sound spectrum of the five visible planets, okay, cover 8 octaves, almost identical to human hearing range. God is really a musical being. God is the author of music because He is song. He is music. Now, what is the counsel of Ellen White with regards to this? When turned to good account, music is a what? Blessing. Continue reading.
God is often made one of Satan's most attractive agencies to his narrow, and the music is the unconcentrated bright light of the world.
Now, what are the effects of music? It's either could be a blessing or a terrible curse. Tatandaan nyo, hindi niya lang sinabing curse, kundi terrible curse. I will explain to you later on why are these things very important to understand. Listen how this research talks about music. Si Dr. Howard Hanson, siya po ay American Journal of Psychiatry, isa po siyang writer nito, and isa po dun sa sinulat niya, ito po sabi niya, music is made up of what? Ingredients, many ingredients, and according to the proportion of these components, it could be what? Soothing or invigorating, ennobling or vulgarizing, philosophical or orgiastic. Now listen to this. It has powers for what? Evil as well as for good. Another one by Max Scoen, The Psychology of Music. Ito sinabi niya, music is the what? Listen to the pronoun. What is the pronoun there? It is the what? Most powerful stimulus known among the perceptive senses. The medical, psychiatric, and other evidences for the non-neutrality of music is so overwhelming that it frankly amazes me that anyone should seriously say otherwise. Ano ibig sabihin nun? Pag tinanong mo sila, may effect ba music sa'yo? Joy? Wala. It's just music. Pero pag nakikinig naman ng music, pag lumabas na, tapos pag nasa banyo, nasa sakyan, yung mga music niya ay naapektuhan yung emotions niya. Tapos sabihin namin, wala naman effect ng music niya. It is just neutral. It is just neutral. That's very dangerous. Sabi dito ni Weinberger, our thinking and our what? I told you, the title is Your Life, Your Music. And how we know God will really reflect our behavior and our thinking with regards to the color of our music, which seems to have direct and unconscious access to the brain's substrates of much, if not all, of our individual lives. Music is a very powerful tool. If God has what? Designed music for the glory of God, the devil also will not be happy if you are glorifying God. Are you following so far?
Yes.
Kaya pala may mga problema tayo sa music later on. Sa second part natin, pag-usapan natin yung rhythm issues. Tapos later on, sa third part, pag-usapan natin yung importance nito sa generation natin ngayon. What music should really be? What music should really be? Now, with regards with this music, sinasabi natin, wala naman pong effects sa akin yan. Wala naman pong problema yung music. Now, let me ask you. Who's the musician behind those music? Sa tingin niya, bakit siya ganun ka-powerful na pang pinakinggan mo na ano ka? Talagang nakikarry away ka. The question is, Who's the music or the musician behind the music? Let me quote to you many of the singers, okay? Many of the singers which they told about their experience with music. Listen to this. It says here, I was directed and commanded by a what?
Another
power. What is that power? The power of darkness that a lot of people don't believe exists. The power of the devil, Satan. This is Charles White. This is somehow a successor of I think it's Jimi Hendrix. It's not Jimi Hendrix. If I'm not mistaken, it's Michael Jackson. I don't know. I forgot it, no? But you may have your research with you. But he is a successor of a certain musician in the late 80s that proclaimed wrong kind of music. Now listen to this. Can you read this for me? Sabi ni John Lennon, no? Sabi ni John Lennon, can you read this? Ready, go.
I feel like a hollow and cold, filled with many spirits. Each one passing through me, each inhabiting me. For a little time, and then maybe through
me. Another one, listen to Keith Richards, Rolling Stones. I need you to read this carefully and with discerning. Tingnan niyo yung mga words na sinabi niya. Ready, go.
Songs here, they think you really know. Really, you're just a being, like being a
science. Like being a science. Sabi niya pa, songs come to me and maze. I didn't do anything except to happen to have been awake when it arrived. So, sino nagko-control? And another one is Bob Larson. Sinabi niya, it happens to us quite often, sinasabi niya sa banda niya, they are three. At ito po nangyari, it feels as though I'm not playing my instrument. Something else playing it, and that same thing is playing all the what? Three of our instrument. Kung si Kim Joshua at saka si Alvan ay nagtutugtog dyan, and then I played something, not knowingly at the same time, ganun din yung plinay niya at the same time. Isn't that? Di ba nakakilabot yun? Who is controlling those things? And these are powerful musicians. Sabi pa dito, that's what I mean when I say it's frightening sometimes. We'll all play the same phrase out of nowhere. It happens very often with us. Sabi naman ni, I forgot who's the author of this, sabi niya naman, it's like I'm on automatic pilot. I think it's still John Lennon. By the time we're halfway to the first number, someone else is steering me. I'm just alone for the ride. I become what? Possessed when I get on stage. Ah, Brother Robert, sa stage lang naman yan. Eh, kami sa ano lang naman, sa MP3, sa cellphone lang naman. Kala mga effect yan sa amin. What is the difference of the stage and your headphones? There's none. There's none. Sabi niya pa dito, sabi naman Michael Jackson, when I hit the stage, this is Newsweek, January 1983. When I hit the stage, it's all of a sudden a what? A magic from somewhere that comes and the spirit just hits you. Why the spirit? According sa pinag-aralan natin kanina, i-relate ko kay Michael Jackson why the spirit is controlling him. He is a what?
Rhythm.
He is a good dancer. One of the prominent dancers of the ages. That's why the spirit just hits him and you lose control of yourself. And who among you here are listening to Beyonce Knowles? Are you familiar with Beyonce? Listen to this. What she says. When I'm on stage, I'm not afraid of my sexuality. Kaya pala, pag nasa stage siya, gano'n na lang forma niya. The tone of my voice gets different. And I'm what? Fearless. I'm just a different person. Isa pang sinabi niya mga kapatid is this. Pag nasa stage daw po siya, which is taken over, kahit putulin mo yung paa niya, kahit putulin mo yung kamay niya, wala siyang pakilang maraso mararamdam. She is totally captured or captivated by what the spirit is called, Sasha Fierce. That is the spirit of controlling her. And a lot more resources. Now, Kuya Robert, hindi naman ako nakikinig sa bagay, ha? Ang pinapakinggan ko lang naman, yung mga simple pop, yung mga melodies na naman. Like, One Direction. Or, ano ba ba? Help me, please. Ano? Ano ba ang mga pinapakinggan?
Taylor.
Yan, Taylor Swift. Sino pa?
Yeah.
And many stuff. And then we thought that they are okay. Okay lang naman sila. Ang mga music naman nila is just, like a queen, mga ganyan lang naman mga music. Wala na may effect yan sa akin. But I would like you to notice, one of those musicians that were carried away by the devil. Who's the musician behind the music? Ito po ay Beastie Boys. Do you know the Beastie Boys? The Beastie Boys are the ones making soundtracks for the young people. Yung mga malilit lang talaga. And can you just imagine, they are creating these soundtracks for those young people, young children. What do you think will happen to them? Ito sinabi nila, we were doing what? Witchcraft. Trying to do witchcraft music. And the little children are listening to that. SpongeBob, SquarePants, like soundtracks of Barbie, Disney. Who are controlling this music? Why? It is very, very powerful. I can show you the world. Ang ganda, di ba? Anong world yung sinasabi doon? Actually, it's a different world. Kung mapasahin yung lyrics, it's really a different lyrics. It's a different world. And then we say, wala namang effect sa amin. They are just... How about this? Si Brian Wilson, kinote daw po siya sa Juice Segel's article. Goodbye surfing, hello God. Can you read this for me? Ready, go.
I'm doing the spirit of sound, a wise spirit of sound, religious music, that's the whole
thing. This is what scares me a lot. Ready, go.
That's where I'm going, it's going to scare a lot of people.
Now, who among you here are familiar with, I think this is not yet, Tony Amos or Tori Amos? I think hindi na kayo familiar dito. It's just within the 90s. Sabi niya dito, Tori Amos sang a song called Father Lucifer and stated, I wanted to marry Lucifer. I don't consider Lucifer as an evil force. I feel his presence with the music. I feel like he comes and sits on my piano. And each time ako nagpe-play siya, you would just really imagine that pag nagsalita siya, tumitirip yung mata niya. And she's really captivated. And you will find that even in her concerts, many people will be found as well hypnotized with these evil spirits. Now the question once again, who is the musician behind the music? The devil knows well how to play with our music. Later on, we will discuss about Christian music. What are the problems with Christian music? And then we will discuss rhythm issues. For us to understand, ano ba talagang tama, ano ba talagang mali? Paano ba namin madi-decipher talaga, ano ba dapat, ano bang hindi dapat? Because the body explains it very well. Kagaya ng DNA music natin kanina, it explains that it has a beautiful music. Who among you here are listening to One Direction? Don't raise your hand. Sabi ng isa, meron nag seminar about music. And then, sabi nung isa may lumapit doon sa next seminar, doon sa lalaki, sabi niya, Sir, na-consider niyo ba yung One Direction? What's One Direction? Hindi alam ko sino next seminar. Anyway, sabi niya, dalawa lang naman yung pangit na music nila. Ilan daw? Dalawa lang. Pero alam niya, nag-research itong lalaki, next seminar,
ni-research na yung dalawang kanta, and ina-research na na isang music ay hindi pa kasama doon sa dalawa na yun. And this is the music. Sabi dito, the part is what? Ending. But it's now or never. What's the notes of this? Nobody's going home tonight. DJ got the floor to shake. The floor to shake. People are going all the way. Yeah, all the way. I wanna stay up all night, hold on to the feeling, and don't let it go. Cause we got the what? Floor now. Get out of corn. And listen to this. I wanna stay up all night and do it all with you. One Direction is proclaiming this music. Now, what would happen to us? Kaya pala, ang mga kalalakihan ngayon, pag nanligaw, kung na-influensya ng One Direction, anong way nyo naman ligaw? One Direction din. Ang problema, para nagkamali, no turning back. Hindi kaya i-accept yung pagkaka. Alam, kasi nagkamali na kami, dire-diretso na kami dito. Be very careful with that. Be very careful with that. Now, let me ask you, does music impact the moral character? The moral character. Okay, read this for me. Ready, go.
For changing people's manners and customs, there is nothing better than this.
Now, are you following me so far? Let me give a confession to you. You might be offended with this, but this is the truth. You know what? Even by what you wear right now, how you behave right now, your music could be dead, could be recognized, could be deciphered. Malalaman kung anong uri ng music meron kayo, anong music meron ako, by the way we wear. Kung ano tayo mag-behave, the music that we are into will usually reflect who is inside. Who is inside, and eventually will be reflected out. Side. Can you read this for me? Ready, go. So, examine the what? Music, it practices. That is why no wonder Ellen White has mentioned that if the what? The thoughts are wrong, the feelings will be wrong. Because why? The thoughts and feelings combined make up the what? The moral character. When we decide that as Christians, we are not required to restrain our thoughts and feelings, we are what? Brought under the influence of evil angels and invite even their presence and their control. No wonder some of us are being controlled by the devil, by the music we are listening to. And that's no other why. That is why at some point of time, it also, what, affects our moral character. Now, my friends, I would like to share to you this quotation that is very, very important. Can you read this for me once again? Ready, go.
This forms a part of God's worship in the forest above, and we should endeavor in the forest
above. Listen, once again, before ko yan yung last part, ano sinabi? Yung music daw po natin, ano, it's taking part of the music or worship in the courts above. Now, let me put it this way. If we are having this worldly music, do you think it will fall in harmony with the worship in the courts above? What do you think? Could it be in harmony? No, it hardly could. Kasi talaga hindi siya makakabagay doon. Kaya pala, no wonder, when we go to the church, tapos ang pinapakinggan natin ay yung mga medyo mas spicy na mga music. When we go to the church, yung mga music sa church ay ano? I surrender all. Ang boring. So ngayon, ang gagawin mo, bakit ang boring ang music namin? Palitan natin music, tapos mag-apply tayo ng mga music na kung saan very jolly, very lively. And then not knowingly, we're already distorting what real kind of music is. Pinapasok na natin yung... Mamaya ko na i-discuss yung bagay na. Pinapasok natin yung mga rhythm, yung mga music that is not really appropriate with the church. Not just with the church, but even for our lives.
I tell you, it's very important to decipher our music. Kasi, ganito pa mangyari. Kung di po natin siya i-decipher niya, ano sa tingin niya mangyari sa atin sa langit? Kunwari si Luis, ang ganda ng music niya doon. Tapos ako, ang music ko ay rock and roll. Pagdating ko sa langit, do you think, I will really be out of place. And the music, yes.
What should we most consider? The lyrics or the melody?
Yeah, that's a very wonderful question. And unfortunately, that will be discussed in the second part. Pero let me just tell to you. Kung melody ay part niya ay lyrics, tapos ang harmony and rhythm part niya music. Which is more important in the three? God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. They are all important. So in other words, both are important. I will explain to you that later on. We will be discussing the importance of lyrics and music. What is really important? What really matters most? Is it the lyrics or the music? We will explain that later. But the point here is this. Let us always remember that our music will always reflect how we worship God. Because it says here that singing as part of what? Religious service is a what? As much an act of worship as is prayer. So therefore, ang music ko ay prayer ko sa Panginoon. Now let me ask you, if your music is worldly music, what kind of prayer do we have? Worldly prayer. If I have a heavenly music, what kind of prayer do I have? You know what? Our prayers are music, and our music are prayers to God. That is why when we sing songs to God, that is really a sweet music to Him. When we pray to Him, that is the sweetest music that we could ever hear. And the main point here is this. How we really know God, our relationship with God, will always reflect our music. Mahirap tanggapin doon first, but I would like to tell you, your relationship with God, to God, will still reflect what your music are, what your movies are, what your deportments are, what your relationships are, because it really will reflect who God is in our lives. Another question, my friends, sino mas pipiliin ninyo? Yung walang ginawa para sa inyo, si Satan? O yung ginawa at binigay lahat para sa bawat isa natin, yet doesn't expect anything in return? Who would you choose? I give you the choice. It's either you reflect your life, your music, with Satan, or you reflect it with God. There is no middle ground. These are all only but one choice. It's either we go with God or we go with Satan. So anything else? The main point here is this. Your music reflects your life, and your life reflects your music. Sige. Question. I'm done. Second part of time.
If you know the person, it also...
Sige na, tagalo mo na.
Sir, another if you know the person, it songs, or the personality of the person, if you hear your song, or...
I don't know.
If you know the person, the character or the personality, if you hear
her song, even you will not hear it. It will eventually reflect. Let me give you an example. No, I have a friend na kusang eh, very ano siya, very mayumi siya na babae. Sa small group namin siya. And then one time, nakatabi ko siya, hindi ko nakilala. May bumps na siya, meron siyang tawag dito? Yun, you don't know that. Meron siya eyeliner, tapos yung lipstick niya. Medyo violet. Oh, goodness, ano nangyari dito sa babae nito? Tapos, yung shoes niya, it's different. Is this the one that I really have known? At alam nyo? I was able to recognize that even before she sat by my side, I could recognize what kind of music she wears or she hears. And eventually, it proves, nung pinasok niya na yung headset niya, I heard loud rock and roll music. I heard loud rock and roll music. Now, of course, there will always be exemptions. But always remember, it could still reflect who you are by the music you are practicing. By the research, ganun yun. By the research, ganun yun. Bakit? Let me put it this way. Noong high school ako, ang buo ko talaga bisngay. Ano yung bisngay? Yung ate? Tapos mahaba dito, tapos yan. Okay. And you know what? Noong nakalinig na ako ng Psalm 41, simple plan. Little by little, my change, my hair change in its way. Naging spikes na siya. Naging isa-isa na siya ang gano'n. And I just say, oh, wala na may effect sa akin yung music. But eventually, it tells who I am. It tells who I am. It tells who I am. So whether you like it or not, it will really tell. According to the research, let me read to you, Maina, sinabi. Sabi dito, for changing people's manners and what? Customs. There is nothing better than music. Ito pa sinabi niya. If you would know if a people are well governed and if its laws are good or bad, examine the music it practices. I would still make sure that my music will glorify God. So that's all for this morning. I hope that you have learned something. The second portion, we'll be discussing rhythm issues and rhythm issues in the Christian world. And then the last part will be in this last days. What is the importance of music? Okay, sige, sir.
Isang clarification lang po. Kapag tayo po ba ay gumagamit ng music o nakikinig ng music, kinakailangan po ba talaga na ito ay pumupuri lang po talaga sa ating Panginoon o mayroon pa tayong kinakailangan i-consider?
You mean choosing the best of music for a loved one?
Oh, kasi, oh, para maganin. Ito ba ay hindi dapat sapagkat hindi ito nakafocus din sa ating Panginoon? Sapagkat parang yung topic natin ay focus talaga sa Panginoon yung dapat natin pakinggan at gagamitin.
Okay, so that's a very wonderful question. You know what? Love songs are very challenging issues. Let me ask naman, sir. Is the music that you are listening to appropriate with the right principles of relationship? Consider that. Kasi kung tama nga yung rhythm niya, tama yung music niya, but it is not with the right principles of relationship, medyo tagalitin tayo. Kunwari ganito, yung mga music na, give me an example of a love song. How about, ano? Hindi po love song yan. Ano? Sige, give me an example of love song.
Hello.
Forevermore. Now, consider the lyrics of Forevermore. Is it appropriate with the principles of relationship? I'm not saying that it's wrong, no? Consider the principles of it, if it is what? In the right principles of relationship. Yun ang kailangan consider sir. Kasi ganito yan eh. Be very careful enough. We might accept things. Pero eventually, yung exemption natin, nagiging way siya na mag-glorify natin yung tao kaysa sa Panginoon. That's very dangerous. I would strictly answer you with that kasi it is very dangerous pag sometimes bibigyan natin siya ng exemption in a sense para lang maiano yung gusto natin. But always remember, is it what God wants for you to sing for that woman? Ganun pa rin yan. Kung hindi man sa babae, direct mo kung anong gusto ng Panginoon para doon sa babae niya. If that's really appropriate, but if that is, let me put it this way, if that is overlapping who God is, better take it off. Kasi yun lang ang danger ng self. Yun lang talaga danger. May mga love songs tayo na pinupuri na you are my everything. Now let me ask you, is it the right principle that you are my everything? Bakit?
You are my everything.
Is that the right principle? Who is your everything? Yun, may mga bagay po na gano'n, no? Na namimiss, na overlap natin yung Panginoon. Kaysa sa ano? May mga songs po na gano'n, no? You're my everything, more than anything, my dear, gano'n, pangalan ng babae. And then not recognizing, she belongs to the words of the song, she's always on my thought every minute, every hour. So, nawala na yung concept na sa may Panginoon dito sa music na to. But let me give an example. How about yung song na A Good and Perfect Gift? Many, many years ago, God wrote a perfect story when He made the man and the woman. Tapos na doon pa sinasabi na, God really have created a perfect and good gift, which is marriage. So sino nag-glorify doon? You give it for the woman, but still glorifies God. Still glorifies God. Mas i-explain natin mamaya, sir, further issues with regards to that. But that is my direct answer with that. I hope that suffice. Okay? So thumbs up. Sige po. So what's the next time? Ano pong next na natin? Part 2 na tayo.